one on your right. We're heading out again through the grapevines. Go ahead, one on your right.
This is fun while you are. Well, we probably should have taken the reason to check. We went, we were in a little bitty town of Navarette last night. And we're wandering around a little town, and all we had was the still
camera. In 400 yards, turn left.
And when we were wandering around, well, we saw a church there. Nice looking church, old. 16th century, I think it was, or 15th century, whatever. And so I looked, and
turn
well,
left.
The door was unlocked, so we went in. And well, you see the pictures. It was unbelievable. There was the altar area was all in gold, and they said it was gold from the Incas, and we think it's the Incas from
either Mexico or
from Mexico.
Peru. Mexico, I think.
And that the
Spanish explorers and
Spanish guys brought back with them.
Yeah.
But it was unbelievable. Cathedral for such a little bitty town. Amazing. Just amazing. Navarette, that was. Awesome. We're going to the wine museum today. Here, maybe taste a little bit of vino. Who knows?
We had a really good afternoon meal yesterday. It was awesome.
Oh, that's right.
Totally awesome. This is like a castle.
Yeah, Suzanne had a veal stew.
Oh my gosh, it was
great. And I had your basic chicken, but it was tasty beyond belief. It just, I've never had chicken like that before.
Look at this beautiful building.
Oh, it's a castle ahead here.
Is there a sign?
Looks
like a castle.
Yes.
No sign. What is it?
A castle out here in the country. I'm sure it has some historical significance.
Awesome.
That's a pretty little town right there.
Bodegas de Nastia Vivianco. There's a winery right there. That is a beautiful old town.
This is Briones. This is the town.
Briones.
Bear right and then turn right.
There's a brown sign to help guide us.
Now, is the brown sign the one we want?
Oh, this is a different one. Yeah, the museum. The Museum of Wine Culture. See.
Destination ahead.
Oh.
No, that's for the town.
Are you sure it's not? This is our wine, the culture de vino?
Oh, this is it.
Culture of Delfino here.
Well, that one was easy to find.
I don't know if we can read that. It's totally
interesting.
Look at this. This is the
That's gonna be
wine
super glare.
At the end of the road, turn right.
Here she comes. And we're going to tour a wine museum today. I want you to see some of this way out there in the distance. It's pretty glary. I can't see too much in my glass. There's a castle on the hill. And we're going to probably drive down there and see what that's all about.
The town is neat. Look at it.
I already forgot the name of it. What's the name of this town?
Oh, I forgot.
It's just another little Spanish town, and always right in the middle.
I recognized it.
Right in the middle, there's always a big cathedral.
Look at the end of this apartment building.
It's just unbelievable.
It has a painting. Can you see the end of the apartment building? It has a painting.
Oh, yeah, I see it right next to the tree here. Yeah, there's a painting on the wall over there.
I think I dropped the town.
Whatever that is. That's amazing. Neat.
They have roses planted at the end of the rose of the vines.
Yeah, and of course, right. Yeah, rose bushes in the grape vineyard. That's pretty cool. That's the cool stuff here. I'd take a picture of the museum here, but it's looking right into the sun, so we can't do it. And the mountains are in the background. Cool. Suzanne out here wandering around. We just came out of the museo. And you can see the town in the distance over there. Beautiful little town. And the name of it is something in Spanish. And it's a tree over here. Some kind of
Weird tree. Look at the size of that trunk on that tree. Woo!
And it's pretty cool.
Now I'm going to switch around over. Oh, turns out this is an olive tree. See all the olives in there? That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I'm not too familiar with olive trees, but they keep it pruned way back, I guess, so they can reach the olives. That trunk is... tree looks young, but the trunk looks old. All right. If it looks like olives, what's it taste like? I bet you they're bitter now.
Oh, yeah,
they gotta be pickled and processed or something. I don't know how they do olives. The sun's a little bit more conducive to film the wine museum we just went in. This place was really impressive. Wow. Looks like just a building, but when you get inside, it's awesome. And you go around, you pan around, you see the mountains in the background. Really neat place. Woo!
Beautiful river, and there's a Roman bridge over there.
Uh-oh.
Can't see it probably, but out my window I can see it. Get before we get boxed in. These streets are so narrow.
Get boxed in, all right.
And we're kind of near the center Urbano, and looks like I don't like the looks of that. I'm going to turn around. There's a thing, there's a road that goes up there. You want to try it?
Watch behind you.
Yes, I was. There's nobody behind us. You want to try going up?
Okay.
This may be a mistake.
Yeah, because there could be a big sign that says you can't come there.
You can't get there from here. There's a place to turn around right there, though, if I can. It's almost frightening here. There it is up there, darling. Man, are we up there? Talk about a vantage point. Woohoo!
Okay, the suits are parking.
Oh my gosh. Old guy's looking at us like, these must be Americanos. I waved to me, so he's alright. You're alright. Picture or two? I think so.
This is or else out your window, either way. Here.
Let's stop here for just a minute. There's nobody coming.
Sure. I can't see what I'm getting, but I hope I'm getting...
And that's the river Ebra or something like that?
Yes, I think it's
one of the main rivers goes through here.
There's a whole
the way
bunch
runs
of rivers.
Along the river here, river bottom, for quite a ways, I think. We got Najira to our left, and to the right is takes you to Burgos. In that direction.
Watch your mirror.
Yes, I'm watching mirrors. This is the narrowest street we've been on so far. And this little car fits through here with about 2 inches on each side.
Uh-oh, is this a blocked in?
No.
I don't
know.
This
is a fountain.
This is the road.
A font on the top here. And if we get to anything that's bigger up here, I'm going to put in the town Najera.
I don't know that this is going to get us up. I think we... I don't know, dear. Maybe.
Oh, it's still fine, huh? Oh my God, what'd that get us into? Actually, the road's a little better here. The
Okay. Now there's somebody up here.
Okay, we've got to the top here, and this is the monastery or something. There's construction going on here, so we're turning around to go back.
They're storing this over here as well.
We're in a church here, and they say this is King Sancho II or something like that, Suzanne told me. Apparently, they have determined by x-rays and stuff that he's actually in there. That's pretty cool. And then we're going to go up here and show you this stained glass window. It's pretty amazing. Shows the battle of where this king was driving the Moors out of Spain. It's quite a battle, apparently. We're in Roncesvalles, just over the border from France. We're just into Spain, and we're driving around, and we had run out of memory on the CD card that I had in here, 32 gigabytes of video. And we're here, and there's Suzanne, and we're going down here to have a carniche, I think. And we just finished a tour of all the historical buildings. We're about to leave Roncesvalles. Another car's down here below the big albergue. You couldn't actually go into the albergue. It's closed now. Till the next batch of pilgrims be arriving. They'd be arriving any time now. It's a little afternoon. And I think they start opening it for pilgrims at 2.
We are on the way to Itzaba. Itzaba? And we went to Roncesvalles this morning. It was really cold and gray. So it's looking a lot better now. We're enjoying the warmth of the sun.
Seven kilometers from France, as you can see on the sign. And you can see the trickle headed for El Franco. And you can see the clouds coming in probably from the ocean over the Pyrenees.
Yeah, we're going through the Pyrenees.
We're very close to France now, cruising along, heading east.
Yeah, so. Okay, we are coming into our little town. Oh, maybe not. Larbelagua? Yeah, Itzaba. We're here, Itzaba.
Yards, turn right.
Okay, we're into the sun big time. Okay, well, let's drive through the town and look, see what we see for hotels. Okay. All right.
Here we are. We're, north of Itzaba. That's where we spent the night last night. We're going to stay another night tonight. And we're almost into France. It can't be more than maybe 5 to 10 kilometers ahead. But just, it's so pretty here in the Pyrenees. It's unbelievable. It's just beautiful. We just came out of the Corkscrew region and looking at the Roman bridges. There were several Roman bridges right behind us. Excuse me, it's a little bit too dark. Oh man, look at the huge, you can't see it. Huge herd of left. There must be several hundred. But anyhow, maybe I think we have to come back out the same way. We'll get some video of the Roman bridges on the way out. Because there's a couple of them are really spectacular. Old bridges. A little sheep doo-doo in the road there. Anyhow, coming to France. We'll film some more when we get there.
Closed here.
Most everything is closed right now around here.
because it's off season. So we're in a pretty good sized hotel last night. For a long time we were thinking we're the only ones there, but it was fine. Oh yeah, we found a little restaurant last night.
Yeah, gourmet restaurant.
The restaurant we were looking for was closed. So some woman on the street told us about Lola's. L-O-L-A. And so we said, all right, gotta have some meat. So we went there and gosh, it looked like it was closed, but we opened a door and then one of the automatic lights came on. So we went in and we were in a little hotel, like back down a dark alley. It was weird. But we went in there and gee, what an awesome restaurant. It was, they have a menu of the day. And I had a trout for dinner. It was awesome. Suzanne had stuffed something. What was it? Stuffed
pimento, but it's red bell pepper.
Yeah, stuffed pimento, which is red bell pepper. Oh, County Road. Doot, doot, beep, beep.
It's like a little tourist area.
But anyhow, the food was awesome. It was just spectacular.
Balagua. So that's the
river.
Community, Balagua.
It's pretty small right here.
It looks like we're going to be doing some climbing. So that was it for the valley. The peaceful valley.
There's Altuez up ahead, I think is. I don't, it's not really, but I kept thinking about Lance Armstrong climbing these mountains on his bicycle, winning the races, and he was not running on his own power. Mechanical bicycle racer.
Okay, we'll have more later. Climbing out of the Roncal Valley. There, if we could get a picture of the valley going back that way.
I'm thinking when we go over the top, we're in France.
Mm-hmm.
We'll find out.
Yeah. Okay. You can see the valley. There's no way.
Oh, those are goats, I think. Or, no, they're wild. Those are the wild ponies.
They're not wild, though. They're wearing belts.
Are they? Anyhow, we're coming up the Pyrenees over here. That's the real deal there, boy. The big peaks of the Pyrenees. That's kind of where we're headed. But man, is this spectacular. Look down there. That's where we were. You can see the road we were on down there. It was all around. You can see the road where we came up. All kinds of corkscrews. And Asaba, where we were, is back down that valley down there a ways. And I mean, there's beautiful stuff everywhere up here. This is some of the most spectacular stuff I've seen in a long, long time. Yeah, we were thinking those were the wild Pollock ponies over there, but some of them have bells on, so we're thinking not. And I'm not sure if this is the border or not. I don't think we're quite there yet. But boy, it's a long way down there. Woo-hoo!
Well, we're driving still through the Pyrenees, and it is an area for cross-country skiing, but nothing is open. Nothing is open. None of the little chalets are.
And we just crossed through 1,725 meters.
This is super rocky. It's hard to imagine that they ski here, but maybe they get a ton of snow. And for cross-country,
chalet,
it's good.
Or something up there.
Yeah, there's ski trails for cross-country, and there's little chalets marked all along the route.
And it says we're now at 1,740 meters of altitude, and we're going up more. Beautiful, just beautiful. But it's we're on the France side now, obviously, of the Pyrenees, and it's much cloudier.
Yeah, much damper feeling.
And it's cold out. I mean, yeah. It's cold out there.
Very
it's
got to
be, I guess, high 30s, low 40s.
But thank goodness it's not too windy.
No, pretty calm. Lots of fallen rock on the road. You got to watch out.
Somebody wrote graffiti on the building. And this word.
They're big into graffiti around here. I don't know.
Well, I don't think we've had as much as in the States.
There's a pull off here, but somebody would wig out on me, so we'll keep going.
Okay, we're going to have
And now we're at 1790 meters of elevation.
All right, we're going to have more later. Look out the side window. Every time I do that, I get blocked.
We're getting, here you go, it's clear
every
here.
Every single time.
Now we're getting into
Amazing.
The cloud layer. And we've crossed over 1,800 meters.
Now, this makes sense. This side, it looks like you could ski, and there's the lift. And it's much more.
Let's see if I can get Suzanne on the gondola lift over here.
Hey.
Nice. Anyway, got up on top of it here. Coming down to, I'm going to ease along here, let her film.
I'm going to turn it off.
Okay.
Yeah. Bonita de queso?
That's what it said.
They live on bread and cheese here. Trust me.
And I guess this is the headquarters for the ski area right here. Wow, it's not much.
No, it's not. It looks like the caretaker's office.
I haven't seen a big parking area or anything.
No, why not? It's kind of weird. Maybe we're...
I don't know how in the world they get up here when it's all covered with snow. I mean, we're way up here.
Okay, let me turn it off while we're getting this a bunch of break. Okay, we came over the top of the ski area and we came into this little town. We're not sure if it's Altariz. Yeah, Arete. 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 A-R-E-T-T-E, a rat. And we're definitely in France. There was a big marker back there.
Okay, if we go...
Dawn.
If we go to the right here... Let's
Luge
go...
Luge
Let's check out this town. And we got to remember, though,
Station
we got
de Ski, La Perrière Saint-Martin.
This is the big ski village.
Mm-hmm.
This is probably where everybody comes up to.
Yeah, and parks. And then they get taken over there.
Oh, there's
a part of it.
There's the big chair lifts right there.
Yes. And we're coming to a roundabout.
Oh boy, I just remember how to get it back out of here.
And this is definitely the France side.
Let's see, would you ask for Conlici here?
Mm.
Here's the ski area. What is it?
La Pierre Saint-Martin. You're at a roundabout.
Yes, I know. It's just not sure where I'm going.
Tout direction. Commerce Center Station. See, they take you, I think, in this big giant up to the top where we were a while ago. They move, those are the people movers. Okay, where's the lifts? Okay. Been trying to see some wildlife, and look, I finally found some goats.
Mountain goats.
Yay!
Mountain goats right in the highway.
Oh, that's not good. There.
Edit.
Yeah, we'll be doing editing in this section. There they are, the mountain goats. Impossible. And there they are, right over by the city. Okay.
the mountain goats.
Let's see if they're going to take off and run. Maybe they're just going to ignore us.
I think those are tame.
Oh, no, they have bells.
Look at the horns on them critters.
Here. Yeah, these guys are tame. They've got their bells on. These aren't wild mountain goats at all. It's easy to scratch your back when you have little horns that are that long.
Yeah, I can. What kind of goats there?
There's a bunch of the sheep that live in the valley. Some of them have marks on them. We passed some a little while ago that looked like they already got their wool sheared off. Some of these look really woolly. I don't know
this
when they cut the...
This one closest to the creek here.
So yeah, yeah.
Looks like a different kind of long hair.
Oh, that might be... Oh, yeah, look at him. He almost looks like a goat.
Is that an Angora sheep?
Maybe he could be a goat. I don't know. No, he looks like he has a sheep, the head of a sheep. Huh. Well, interesting.
Lots more over here. Lots and lots of sheep.
A lot of them have a marking on them.
Hey, no black sheep in this one. That one herd we saw the other day was half of them, more than half of them were black sheep. Okay.
Okay, let's go.
Look at this beautiful trout stream. And the only reason it's beautiful, here's an old Roman bridge. So built by the Romans, I mean way back, long time ago. But while we're checking out this, and I saw a number of nice sized trout in this stream. Really pretty, but everybody needs to see at least one Roman bridge in their lifetime, and there it is. And there's no one right back behind me. I'm going to walk down to that. Oh, another of the old Roman bridges here. I got some serious editing to do there. I was filming when I was walking. But anyhow, this is another one of the Roman bridges. I'm going to walk out here on this one a little bit, and we'll see if we can see some more. Not on the old Roman bridge here now. And it's real overcast right now. I was hoping maybe you could see some of the trout in the stream. Oh, there goes one, but he's real fast. You wouldn't have seen that one. He saw me first. But anyhow, beautiful little trout stream, a Roman bridge. Doesn't get much better than that. See if we see fish or two down here. I don't see any good ones. And I see a couple little ones scooting along, but no big ones right here. That's a new bridge there. And there's undercut on this side. That's probably where the big trout are.
All right. Got a little closer to the structure. We're just south of the south border of Pamplona. And this apparently is an old Roman aqueduct for transporting water. And you can see we're right at the edge of the city here. It's amazingly long. I'll have to do some research and find out. You can see it going off into the distance there, over towards what now is a big freeway. It's just amazing that it still exists and in good shape. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit and look at the stonework for arches. Very tall.
That's an impressive structure.
It is a very impressive structure. We'll have to do some research on how old it is and how they used it.
There's the viaduct.
There's the viaduct from the A15. There's the end of it on this end. And going.
The old Romans were busy people.
Yes, they were.
We got to see it again because we had a detour for a few miles out of our way.
That's a good view. That's a big piece of history still standing. Okay. We're in Punta La Reina. We're going to look at the bridge when we find it. Some of the old buildings in the historical district. This is the church here at Puente de Reina. This is the Iglesia de Santiago.
We're in Puente La Reina.
What did I say?
Okay.
I thought that's what I said.
No, je crois pas.
This is the Punta La... I forgot where we were. This is one of the ancient Roman bridges. There's Bob over there. We're kind of waiting for these bikers to leave. Cyclists are up there. Punta La Reina. We're in Punta La Reina, near Pamplona. It's a beautiful old Roman bridge, medieval. Very interesting. Very famous bridge. Still existing. The river's hardly flowing here. This is at the edge of the old town. And not far from the cathedral we just went into. It's the arch over there. The pilgrims walk into town and across the bridge. And the modern bridge is over there. We're just walking up to the bridge. The sign there for the Peregrinos. And there's your arrow. The bridge, medieval bridge. And there's the residences. People that live here today. You can see the church steeple in the background. Pretty place.
Puente Lorena, the cathedral there is very nice too. Very nice.
You've seen the cathedral of Burgos?
No, we have many in the Burgos.
Okay. I think it will be there.
This is at Unate near Pamplona. Well, we're at the top of the mountain where Bob wanted to come and find. It's on the path of the way. Bob wanted to come and find the Alto with the little some walkers, some pilgrims, and here's the monument to the pilgrims that Bob wanted to see. And up here, this sign, which way is Santiago? This is at the El Perdón viewpoint. And here's the Camino. Coming up. The pilgrims come up this way, up the path. You can see out there the good viewpoint on from both sides. And here's the viewpoint, and there's some pilgrims that have just come up and talked to Bobby, helped them take their picture. It says Mirador El Perdón, the lookout point on the way. There's the path that pilgrims go down after they stop there, and there's one of the big, the A-15 highway down there. It is the Mirador allows you to see for miles and miles and miles. Look all the way over there on that other ridgeline. There's another wind farm. Lots of wind farms here. And this one, of course, that we're standing beneath.